V2PTE Academic. We are providing online PTE coaching and monthly practice test. You can also stay connected with us. Facebook, Instagram and Telegram. For more information visit our WhatsApp on given number. Subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for more updates.
The professor has promised to put his lecture notes online. The professor has promised to put his lecture notes online.
All students in engineering courses spent 1 year working on war experience. All students in engineering courses spent 1 year working on war experience.
Expertise in particular areas distinguishes you from other graduates. Expertise in particular areas distinguishes you from other graduates.
I will need to make sure the school principal knows about the changes. I will need to make sure the school principal knows about the changes.
The student welfare officer can help students with different issues. The student welfare officer can help students with different issues.
I don't understand what the comment on my essay means at all. I don't understand what the comment on my essay means at all.
The number of company bankruptcies skyrocketed in the third quarter. The number of company bankruptcies skyrocketed in the third quarter.
The older equipment has been put at the back of the building. The older equipment has been put at the back of the building.
We will need to make sure the school principal knows about the changes. We will need to make sure the school principal knows about the changes.
Hypothetically, insufficient mastery in these areas slows future progress. Hypothetically, insufficient mastery in these areas slows future progress.
V2PT. V2PT. V2PT.
Many people know that the kangaroo is a marsupial from the family Macropodidae. There are about 69 species of kangaroos in the world. They live in Australia, New Guinea, and the nearby islands. Also, everyone knows that kangaroo females have a special pouch where they carry their cubs. But not everyone knows that a kangaroo has a very short pregnancy term. A baby is born about a month after conception. However, this is not a grown animal ready for life in the outside world. The size of a newborn kangaroo is only a couple of centimeters, and it weighs about a gram. In this embryonic state, the cub makes its way into the pouch, and the tiny kangaroo does not yet have hind legs, so he has to use the front ones. Moreover, the mother does not help him. She only licks the path to the pouch, where the cub immediately starts sucking on a nipple. Well, he doesn't actually suck it, because he's not yet able to. He's too small. Milk is secreted into his mouth with the help of a special muscle. Another peculiar thing about the kangaroo is that it has four nipples in its pouch, and each of them secretes a different type of milk.
2019, a study led by Zurich's Crowther Lab analyzed satellite imagery of the world's existing tree cover. By combining it with climate and soil data and excluding areas necessary for human use, they determined Earth could support nearly 1 billion hectares of additional forest. That's roughly 1.2 trillion trees. This staggering number surprised the scientific community, prompting additional research. Scientists now cite a more conservative but still remarkable figure. By their revised estimates, these restored ecosystems could capture anywhere from 100 to 200 billion tons of carbon, accounting for over 1/6 of humanity's carbon emissions. More than half of the potential forest canopy for new restoration efforts can be found in just 6 countries, and the study can also provide insight into existing restoration projects, like the Bond Challenge, which aims to restore 350 million hectares of forest by 2030.
What do we call the time before noon? What do we call the time before noon? How many sides does a pentagon have? What is the first paragraph of an essay? What is the first paragraph of an essay? How often is an annual conference held in one year? How often is an annual conference held in one year?
P2PT. V2PT.
V2PT. V2PT. V2PT. V2PT.
So, various conclusions. Yes, bees are in decline. These declines are well documented, they are real, and supported by good, strong scientific evidence, which is the only evidence that counts. The drivers of decline are many and varied depending on the species. The effects of pollinator loss could be absolutely huge. So is it a catastrophe? Not yet. But it could be. On the positive side, we are aware of the problem, awareness is being raised all the time, and people are taking action. That, before fix anything, you can recognize a problem. That, at least, is being done.
In my view, it's impossible not to talk about wildlife and not think about its role in livelihoods. And I guess part of that is my own view, part of the research that I do in Africa, in most East and West Africa. I look at the role all humans rely on wildlife as a source of food and also the source of income. And we talk about our wildlife, if we talk about fish, we are talking about what is probably the single most important source of protein for humans across the globe. And so billions or more than a billion people rely on fish as their primary source of animal protein, and most of these people live in poverty. So the management of wild fish resources, in a sense, is incredibly important to livelihoods and health. And also, wildlife tourism is a multi-billion dollar industry. And in many places, such as Africa and South America, it can be the number one source of income. It can be the number one source of foreign income for economies.
For a glimpse of what the U.S. economy might look like in the future, we head to Scandinavia. No country is dropping cash as fast as Sweden. Just 13% of people there reported using cash to buy something last year. But as Maddie Savage reports from Stockholm, some Swedes are concerned that things have changed too quickly.
Next to the cinnamon buns and open sandwiches at this restaurant, there's a large blue sign with the English word cash crossed out. Notes and coins stopped being accepted here a year ago, after staff noticed most people were hardly using them.
It was super rare. I'd say 5%, something like that, in the restaurant was using cash.
That's General Manager Christopher Loeb, who's been keeping an eye on how customers have responded.
There's hardly been any reaction. Almost everybody has their alternative payment method, like credit card. And it's good for both the guests and for us.
He says scrapping cash saves time at the till and helps protect against theft.
There are at least 5 hotspots of floating plastic in the global ocean. These are gyres where circulating currents trap debris. This one, the so-called Great Pacific Garbage Patch, is the largest, with almost 80,000 tons distributed over 600,000 square miles. The scientists teamed up with a charity that collects old fishing gear and other litter from the ocean and gathered hundreds of plastic items to study in the lab. They found plants and animals, including anemones, tiny marine bugs, mollusks, and crabs, on 90% of the debris they examined. As well as creating a semi-permanent floating habitat for coastal species in the open ocean, the researchers say all this plastic could be providing invasive species with rafts that allow them to cross the Pacific. This, they say, is yet another unintended consequence of plastic pollution for the ocean.
There's growing alarm over plunging insect populations, with climate change, habitat destruction, and pesticides all thought to play a role. But now scientists say there's another culprit: artificial streetlights. Researchers from the charity Butterfly Conservation counted caterpillars at the sides of brightly lit roads. Compared with similar stretches of unlit roads, caterpillar numbers were reduced by half, suggesting streetlights can affect the abundance of insects, at least on a local scale. The scientists say with insects in trouble, we should be doing all we can to reduce negative influences. But there are practical solutions, such as dimming streetlights in the early hours, installing motion sensors, or using colour filters to modify the light.
First, there was the keyboard. Then the touchscreen. Some tech companies say a wearable pair of glasses could be the next leap in technology, even if it didn't work out for Google Glass.
In the future, we won't be only limited to our smartphones when it comes to understanding the world around us. So this is our early investment in that future.
The US-based company Snap's investment is this, the Spectacles 3 sunglasses. This third version is smarter than the previous ones. It has 2 cameras. The corner of the glasses lights up when recording video and allows the wearer to put 3D objects in the video. Here are some flowers.
There's a bird, which is really cool.
Users can capture up to a minute of video.
So I spent an hour trying on all these damn jeans, and I walked out of the store, truth, with the best fitting jeans I had ever had. I did better. All this choice made it possible for me to do better. But I felt worse. The reason I felt worse is that with all of these options available, my expectations about how good a pair of jeans should be went up. I had no particular expectations when they only came in one flavor. When they came in 100 flavors, damn it, one of them should have been perfect. And what I got was good, but it wasn't perfect. And so I compared what I got to what I expected, and what I got was disappointing in comparison to what I expected. Adding options to people's lives can't help but increase the expectations people have about how good those options will be. And what that's going to produce is less satisfaction with results, even when they're good results.
Research suggests that some are more susceptible than others, especially those who are self-conscious, anxious, and afraid of being judged negatively by others. So, how can we avoid choking when it really counts? First, it helps to practice under stressful conditions. In a study on expert dart players, researchers found that those who hadn't practiced under stress performed worse when anxious, compared to those who had become accustomed to pressure. Secondly, many performers extol the virtues of a pre-performance routine, whether it's taking a few deep breaths, repeating a cue word, or doing a rhythmic sequence of movements. Studies on golfing, bowling, and water polo find that short rituals can lead to more consistent and accurate performance under
Perhaps you remember the dire predictions from the analysts. The falloff in housing threatened to drag down the entire economy. High energy prices put the kibosh on consumer spending. Runaway inflation was poised to take off. David Wyss is an economist at Standard & Poor's. He says in the end none of those things happened in the final 3 months of last year. For four centuries, the Viking declined. The people of the Shetland Islands off the north coast of Scotland continued to sell their goods through the North European Hanseatic League. The Hanse's merchants bought shiploads of salted fish, and in return the islanders got cash, grain, cloth, and other goods. This lasted until the Act of Union between Scotland and England in 1707. This act prohibited the Hanse merchants from sheltering with Scotland. Consequently, Shetland went into an economic depression. The independent farmers of Shetland had to sell their land and were then obligated to pay rent, eventually becoming serfs.
The first migratory birds from Asia are showing up in Alaska. It's an annual event, but this time the stakes are higher for human beings. The federal government is spending millions of dollars to see if those birds are carrying H5N1, the deadly strain of avian influenza. In Alaska alone, the goal is to test on screen more than 15,000 birds this summer in full. Surveillance effort is still somewhat of a work in progress. Elizabeth Arnold describes it in this National Geographic radio expedition. The first migratory birds from Asia are showing up in Alaska. It's an annual event, but this time the stakes are higher for human beings. The federal government is spending millions of dollars to see if those birds are carrying H5N1, the deadly strain of avian influenza. In Alaska alone, the goal is to test on screen more than 15,000 birds this summer in full. Surveillance effort is still somewhat of a work in progress. Elizabeth Arnold describes it in this National Geographic radio expedition.
This is a poem she wrote in Oregon. We used to own a house on the Oregon coast, which is a lot like Tasmania. It's about a blue moon, which is when you have two full moons in the course of 1 month. And this is called August Moon. One reason I love this poem is that it says something that I don't believe has ever been said before by any poet in any language. This is a poem she wrote in Oregon. We used to own a house on the Oregon coast, which is a lot like Tasmania. It's about a blue moon, which is when you have two full moons in the course of 1 month. And this is called August Moon. One reason I love this poem is that it says something that I don't believe has ever been said before by any poet in any language.
Journalists need to work with a range of technologies. In computer degree, there is a new module in artificial intelligence. The guidelines are due to be updated shortly. The Student Service Center is located on the main campus behind the library.